Hey everyone, this is Matt. Welcome to Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning, the demo. just put that under there, the demo. So yeah, this is a fantasy action RPG. Yeah, I'll talk to you guys some more after we kick into this. Normal. Okay, so we're in game now. I skipped the intro cinematic there for you guys so you didn't have to spoil yourselves or anything.
What do you think this one is then? Alpha? Garani? Could even be a Jotun?
Go on and pull back the sheet though. It'll need to be in our report, one way or the other.
Okay, so this is the character creation of Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning. From now on, I'm just going to refer to it as like Amalur or Reckoning. So, warlike and religious nation. So you get some racials. You get these guys who hardened high seas, kind of like pirates guys. You get again things here, and carrying on. Now, I am going to kind of set this up to the character I'm actually probably going to play in the final version. You can see the female characters there. I'm probably going to go with these guys. I'm going to be a warrior class, focusing on swords and blocking things in my main playthrough of the game. But, you know, I thought I'd check it out for the demo. So we get here some sort of order, justice, so fire resistance, none, plus one experience bonus. So basically this is a god that you want to kind of be a part of. I think I'm going to go with maybe the 10% health or physical. I'm going to go with the war, actually. Yeah, war. And then these are the presets you have here that you can kind of start with. And that's it. Confirm. That's our character.
A human.
There he is.
Not in bad shape. I think we're done.
I'd quite like to name him, actually. Could I call him Jeremy? Okay, I can. Oh my god, Jeremy. Jeremy. Can I call him Ballsack? Oh no, I can't. Can't give him a last name. Just go with Jeremy then. Even though my name's Matt, I just thought I'd go with Jeremy. In the final game, I'll probably call myself Matt.
That's it for you then.
Oh god!
Next time.
Oh god. Oh, where am I? Oh. Oh. Where the hell am I? No! Gee! Dead people! I like how all of them have no distinctive, like, facial things, like, say, a normal human would. Only me. All of the rest were, like, rotten carcasses. Well, that's a pretty interesting opening. That's pretty damn cool. Now, this demo is 45 minutes long. I will cut that down to a considerably less amount of time than that. And backstory-wise, you are a warrior in a fight, without kind of going into too much spoilery details for those guys out there who might want to play Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning. But, yeah, mainly you die, and you somehow come back to life. And that will all be explained throughout the game and through the story and everything. But it's time to actually see what gameplay is like. So this is obviously the PC version. A lot of the footage we've actually seen is of the Xbox version. I've rarely seen any footage of the PC version. So it'll be interesting to see. So that's block. You have your 1 through a 0 as your abilities, it would seem. Escape is your inventory, you've got your quests. Enter to continue, find a way out, that's our main, out of the darkness. Inventory limit, you've got everything. The demo kind of gives you access to some of the areas at the start of the game and obviously lets you explore for about 45 minutes. Little notes that are around. The game, in terms of depth and things, reminds me of something of like an Elder Scrolls game. One of the main designers on Morrowind and Oblivion is actually the executive designer on this game, so I'm not hugely sure about F being the being the actual action button, but hey, loot rusty sword, take. Well, I can't show you the really cool compare system yet, but Let's have a look what we got here. So there's nothing in there. So let's go up to weapons, primary, rusty longsword. And we've equipped it. And it's a rather rusty looking longsword. Okay, so let's move on.
They're all over.
Ooh.
Run!
Oh my god. There's some evil people and some dwarves running. Oh no!
Scatter, children of dust!
Children
scatter
of dust?
Scatter before the might of the Tuatha!
The Tuatha? The little dwarf? What did he ever do to him? How do I get down? I wanna go save them. Damn it. So yeah, this is... It already seems pretty cool. I mean, in terms of the vibrancy of the environment of a fantasy like archetype, it feels to me more along the lines of something like World of Warcraft or Fable. But let's find out what gameplay is actually like here. So here we go. Already impressed by this. Very fluent. Like, it doesn't seem to stop. Like, the actual motion of everything seems very quick. Very powerful, and it almost to me, I thought it was going to play a little bit more like Dragon Age 2's combat, but Dragon Age 2's combat, I should say. But this seems to be a lot more free flowing, kind of like God of War, or Darksiders kind of was a little bit like that as well. Rescue the gnome. Right, so press F and you jump down. Tatula soldiers, right. Dodge an enemy attack and press the space bar, okay. Right. Oh. Right, roll back, let's go for this guy. Oh, right, that's him dead. Let's go for this guy. Did a bit of blocking there. Okay, so loot treasure stack, worn leggings. So now we can put that on in our armor. The one thing I've noticed about this game is it doesn't seem to shy away from the whole hood and numbers and data and all of that kind of stuff.
The Well of Souls.
Right, so they're after this. Oh my god. Well, that's that. Wow. Impressive. I mean, the graphics aren't too in your face and over the top. They're so vibrant and so, you know, oh my god. Well, that's the Well of Souls destroyed. Good job keeping that alive, I guess. I mean, I don't think graphics have to be everything in a game. I mean, if gameplay is so good, and I mean, the story is so compelling, graphics can kind of be forgiven in a way, but I kind of like this graphic style. And I press shift.
Do you hear something?
Oh, yeah. I don't hit anything. Oh! Oh god. Right, okay. This is amazing. Combat feels really good. I mean, I wish there was a few more things, but I guess this is early game. You're supposed to get a lot more different skills and items and weapons and things, and the actual combat's supposed to be very free-flowing. Well, that's what the developer diaries and stuff kind of say. Or even, oh, press escape and equip it as a secondary weapon. Crude birch longbow. Okay. Now, how do I cycle? Oh, so I can just cycle between these. Okay. And then there doesn't seem to be a way for me to free target with it. So I'm going to do it like this.
Archers up ahead. Let's shoot them before they see us.
Oh my god, that felt good. It's stealth mode. Or stealth eye indicator, as they're saying it. So if they see me, it'll start glowing orange and filling up. But right behind him, I can press this and do a rather brutal stabby animation. Which is quite violent, you know, for a game that is about, you know, kind of, it looks the way it does is what I'm trying to say here. There we go. Got me some top armor now. So we've got these two guys here, which I'm going to try to sneak up on with the daggers, and then I'm going to switch to my sword and actually, there we go, and kill the guy next to me. Alright, so let's switch over to the sword. Where did he go? There he is. fight him. I like how the camera is very... It isn't too focused on you all the time. I think that's quite a unique thing to do. I very rarely see that kind of stuff. Oh my god. Plants are growing.
Cave blossoms only respond in the presence of magic.
No?
Perhaps there is more to you than it seems.
Right, so number one. To activate your abilities and then use that. Holy!
Incredible.
Oh my god.
What are you?
That is really cool. Ow. Oh, look at this cute little guy. Cute little spider. Hello. I will name you Jeremy too. I think he likes it. Alright, let's keep going on with this. I am enjoying this a lot. I mean, I was kind of skeptical because people were saying many different things about the game and stuff like that. And I know review copies are already out there, such as IGN's Colin Moriarty is already kind of doing a review in progress of this game. Oh! Oh no, Jeremy! Jeremy Jr.'s here! But he wants to kill me! Why would you want to kill me, Jeremy Jr.? Oh god, my mana's low. Here we go. Yeah, I'm not a massive fan of magic either. Oh, that didn't very effective, was it? Gotta be fairly close, I guess.
Not more spiders! Burn them! Burn them!
Burn them? Yeah. Right, I'm gonna... Oh god. I'd much rather do this. Well, I kinda got... I got injured there. But... Jeremy Jr. Jr. Jr., what are you doing here? I'm such a good to your room! Yeah. That's what I do to spiders. Sorry for those arachnophobes out there, by the way. I am not hugely scared of those kind of things. Spiders, really. They don't matter. They used to. When I was younger, they used to scare me, but I've kind of grown out of being scared of spiders, I guess. Now I'm just scared of snow and dentists. Clearly, after today. Completely different story. Twitter followers know what I'm talking about. Music kicking in. It's good to know. Oh, God. Jump in here. Jump in. Nope. It's very green. Oh god. Sinister music is sinister. Let's climb this staircase here. Right. Laboratory. Loading screens seem fairly fast. A little bit of texture popping. But yeah. Fairly impressive. I've got all the graphics on highest and anti-aliasing on the highest and everything like that, so I'm recording this in 1080p but throwing it out to you guys as 720 as well.
I'm not certain what's caused it, but somehow...
Butt shot.
Yes, as I was saying, I'm not sure what...
Butt shot. That's what he was trying to say.
Sir, Mr. Hughes, the dwarf
Mr. Dwarf. Oh, no. He's dead, Jeremy! Get out of here! Jeremy! It's the pigs! They're here to kill you!
He's a friend that you may be able to help. No matter what else, stay alive!
That is one badass dwarf fella. Amazing. Amazing. Stabbed a dude. Oh god. Like, oh, the dwarf. What the hell is that thing through there? Is he holding... Oh god. Mini boss? Okay, now this is gonna be fun. I think he thinks so too. It's a rock troll! Oh my god. Right, let's attack you. Right. Oh shit. Right, let's actually try this. Oh god! That looks like more like a frost troll than a rock troll, but okay. Right. Oh man. This is actually quite challenging. Right, let's fight this guy. Smash him and then attack. Beat you up, you big oaf! Die! Die! Oh god, he slapped me. Alright, you're going down. You are going down. Oh yeah. Oh my god, what? I just threw like a spear through his head. It's kind of like a quick time event, but the more you spammed the spacebar, the more XP you got, which is pretty cool. I didn't see that until like a little bit. Squire's ring. Right. Some more healing-y stuff. Let's get that Squire's ring on there. Accessories. Squire's ring plus 5 health. I knew it would be a good thing. Right. And I think that is all I really want to do. It told me something about some sort of thing. I'm not sure there's anything I can do with that at this point. Armor. I don't feel like I picked up anything better than I currently had. Boots. Nope. So I think that's it. Yep, that looks like it. Let's carry on. That was definitely fun, and it was definitely more challenging. It looks like we're actually going to get out now into the world. Oh my god. Stuff just happened. Oh, we leveled up. We leveled up for the first time. Escape to level up. And level up. So we got to choose kind of our way to go, kind of where to put a point into. I think... I don't actually know what I've got a point in already. What do these do? Which one's good for, like, attacking people? Allows you to repair your arms and armor, as well as forge new equipment. There we go, I think that's probably good. Level 3 in blacksmithing is probably a good place to be. And we have 3 points here. So, harpoon, snag an enemy, and drag it towards you. Okay, so we'll put a point in that. Let's put additional damage with your longsword attacks. And charge spell. Okay, yep. Or charge special, I think it said. So I think... Yeah, here's this charge spell now. Pretty cool. Pretty cool looking. And we have 2, which is a harpoon. Okay. Right, that makes complete sense. We've got some guys here.
I told them we needed more guards.
Yeah, but you did. You have no active quest. Press escape and access your quest log to set one. That's what I imagine it would be. Saying, that is my active quest. This. Speak with Fate Weaver in Gortheart. Right, is there a map? Ooh, there is a map. So this is the Fate Weaver. World map. Ho! Ho! Now this is the meat and potatoes of an RPG game. Wow. Okay, so I guess at some point you'd have to get across the sea? Maybe, and get to this area? There seems to be a... Oh my god, there is quite a lot of stuff. Wow. Okay. And obviously with side quests and stuff, this is going to be a fairly large game. I mean, outside is very pretty looking. You can hear the sounds of the fauna, you know, the little shrubberies and stuff moving. Maybe it's just because of the way it's being used here in the tutorial. Right, so F. We've got a very odd camera angle here. Smash the spacebar! Oh my god. Oh, what happened to him? He got lodged in a wall. Oh my god, amazing. That was beautiful,
what?
Dude.
How? What are you?
Right, so now we have to choose our own destiny. Kind of like, we currently have the Fateless one, I guess. And I kind of want to go Brawler as my kind of like my second one to equip. Because this one doesn't really do anything. It's just kind of like a newly resurrected thing. Under Might, you have all these other ones you can unlock. At different might levels that you put into your skill tree. All of them count on the others as well, as you can see. So, like, the more you put into all of them, you can unlock, like, these kind of mixed trees where you're kind of a warrior mage kind of guy and stuff like that. Which is quite a cool way to go. you can kind of mix all of these stuff together. And I love the artwork as well. That looks awesome. But I'm going to stick with Brawler right now. I got 15% attack damage bonus and a 10% block efficiency. You only need 1 point in might for that. You have 1 point in everything, I think, at this point. So you could always switch between these unlocked destinies if you want, but I'm going to stick with Brawler. All right, so I got to go meet this guy called Arden. Oh, item awarded. Congratulations. You have unlocked the Infernal Helm. It'll be in the... Oh, cool. That's one of the things that you can unlock. But it won't let me continue. Oh, there we go. That dude is so broken. You now have 45 minutes to explore Odorath, the lands of Delantar. I can't say these things. Why do they give me hard names? The time halts when you pause the demo or are in a conversation. That's it. They don't show you it, it would seem, though. They don't show you the timer. Let's just quickly check. No, it doesn't seem like they're showing... Oh, there we go. 44:51 remaining. Which is pretty cool. So, from now on, I'm going to cut this even closer than I did before. Because we're probably already... Actually, my proper recording is probably already a few 20-odd minutes in. So, let's grab some flowers. And let's adventure. And, into a rather dreary-looking wood. Oh, there's some funny-looking fellas over here. Let's go greet them. They don't look hostile or anything. Oh, I guess they don't like that. They don't like me mimicking their ritualistic rants. I like how their helmets look a little bit like the Deku shield from Ocarina of Time. Deku, if you want to say. Huh. The tree men fell. That was fairly easy. Loot treasure. And Altar of Belly. Death's Touch. Shrine's a temporary bonus.
Ooh, me back! Ooh! I need to call claims direct! I had the wrong type of ladder, and I fell.
Oh. That looks like a side quest guy, limping away there. Awesome. Traveling side quest guys, that's just what we want. I think there's some more side quest people here. Wow, there is. Let's have a look at her, Yolven. Hello, Yolven. You are quite a tall lady. Hello. Hello.
Hail, traveler.
Hail, traveler. My voice wasn't too far off. Oh, look at him roll around. Oh, God. No. Go back to rolling around. Go back to rolling around. Oh, God. Oh, jeez. Oh, my health potion. Oh, cool, you can just press R. Oh, that dude in the background's just chilling. That bear back there, he's just chilling on the ground. Oh, now he's like, I'm not going to... Oh, God. Oh, my God. What are they? Wolves. Oh, they look, like, really energetic. Oh, man. Gotta block really carefully in this game. Oh my God, did you see that? Look at bear! Where did that bear fly off to? Oh my God, physics at work there. I have to do a little edit here, slow down just to watch that. Oh my God, that was amazing. Alright, let's finish off these wolves. Oh God, the bash is really cool, the shield bash. Alright, let's keep moving on. We've got treasure sack. I see where we've got to go. Looks like it's down to this place, so let's keep heading this way. Little deer there. What we got here? Shriner's Mithru. Mithru's protection. Mitharu? Okay, whatever. It looks like the place I've got to head to is down here on the local map. So we will head this way. I'll just kind of take you guys in the generic kind of route so you guys can kind of see the environments and stuff. Is this the bear body? This is the body of the bear that flew off. God, he landed far away. He was way over that way. Like, that far pillar you can see between those other two? That's where we were fighting. Wow. We don't want, you know, kind of a restricted area. Like, well, not restricted, but kind of thing. Halt! This space is only available in the full game! to explore other zones, cities and villages, and dungeons. Order your copy of Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning. Oh, we can no go further. Oh my god, Tremor is amazing, look at that. Oh my god! Holy moly, that was amazing. I may have just used like, all of my mana up. That was awesome. That was seriously cool. Well, I think that's, even though I haven't been playing it for that long, this is pretty much all I really want to show. I don't particularly want to delve into the side quests because I don't want to spoil them too much for myself. So, I'm going to fight these spikes here who just spawned. It shouldn't take me too long to defeat these guys. And then, I think that's going to be the end of this little look at Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning. If these guys would stop spawning. I mean, wow. There we go. Okay. Beautiful. So yes, thank you for watching, guys. You can pick up this demo right now on Origin on the PC, Xbox Live, or PlayStation Network. The game comes out full retail, you know, normal full game, not the demo, on Origin on the PC and Xbox and PlayStation. So all three of the major platforms, really. Release date in North America is the 7th of February and the 10th of February in Europe. So, until next time, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!